This is an artist's rendition, because of course we don't see the planet itself.
According to the NASA website, this image is an artist's conception. It's artwork, conceived in the imagination, not real. It could just as easily be this, or this, or this.
Hello, anybody here?
NASA shows an artist's work. What is the artist's name? Was any scientific method used in creating this image? How could we use science to determine what this planet looks like? Where is the planet anyway? Have the coordinates been disclosed? How could anyone else with a telescope independently confirm that this planet exists?
Do you realize what that means? No. Emasculation and experimental surgery on the speech centers, on the brain.
Scientists looking for life on other planets like to talk.
There you go. I totally
yeah.
Be able to do
See,
that.
I love it. And I love the planets.
Oh, yeah, yeah, sorry. Yeah, it's, you know, you got to wear your work.
Kepler-22b isn't on there.
No, it's not, but I could just put it in with a marker. Yeah, yeah. You want to, the experiment to be resolved before you die.
Yeah.
Right, see, so. So
yes. So don't tip off any other scientists.
Before you die.
NASA says this planet is 600 light years away. That's the equivalent of 3.5 quadrillion miles. That might be far enough away that no one else can confirm that this planet exists.
Life on other planets.
NASA says Kepler-22b is in the habitable zone. There is only one planet that we know of in the entire universe that is habitable. So how do we define a habitable zone based on one finding? Where is the science?
2, 1, 0.
NASA chose to name this mystery planet Kepler-22b. What is the Kepler mission? According to the NASA website, their goal is to find life-supporting planets. But why? Why is NASA looking for life-supporting planets 3.5 quadrillion miles away? If or when NASA claims that they find alien life that far away, it is unlikely that anyone else would be able to scientifically duplicate their findings. NASA could have a monopoly on finding life quadrillions of miles away. If NASA is a monopoly, then when they claim they found alien life, you must choose what you want to believe, as you will not be able to scientifically confirm it as fact. In the early 1600s, a man named Johannes Kepler was the first to correctly explain planetary motion. Kepler helped prove that the Sun is the center of our solar system, with the planets orbiting the Sun in ellipses, not circles. Kepler believed that the universe itself was an image of God. He was a devout Christian and a serious student of the Holy Scriptures. Kepler said he believed only and alone in the service of Jesus Christ. In him is all refuge, all solace. Kepler, a lover of peace, believed in Jesus Christ. Because of his Christian faith, Kepler and his wife fled their homeland during the Catholic persecution against Christians at that time. Kepler was also the first to explain the process of vision by refraction within the eye, first to formulate eyeglasses designed for nearsightedness and farsightedness, first to explain the use of both eyes for depth perception, first to explain the principles of how a telescope works. And Kepler was the first to use planetary cycles to calculate the birth year of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Right, see, so.
Yes. So don't tip off any other scientists.